not discriminating between IAS and IPS officer. Thing is, what motivated me to ask this question is because I have read it in many of the blogs, like the people who secured rank within the 100, they only get the IAS post, and the rest of the people, like the associates and that's when they will get the IAS and then ISI and something like that. So,
I agree to your fact. IAS is a premier service and it is meant for an administrative role. Premier services used to have a varied option earlier. You have a different sort of environment now. Earlier environment, politicians were not intelligent. Now you have politicians from Harvard, politicians decide policies. So you really need to excel as far as administration is concerned. It's not easy to be an IAS officer as far as their role is concerned. It is not riskier. It's a room kind of job, a desk office kind of job. IPS officer's job is an outwardly job. So this is the major difference between the services. Earlier also I felt that one should differentiate between these two services, saying that one can do lots here, but one can do lots in IPS also. But yes, I agree to your fact that people with good ranks go for IAS, and more necessarily so, this civil services examination is also called as IAS examination, because premier ranks, people with good ranks, they opt for IAS.